The outgoing boss of Qantas has received a bonus worth more than $10 million as the airline comes under fire over allegations of misleading customers. Live 2 federal politics reporter Fiona Willen in Canberra. Fee, it is not a good look.
So if this is a case of very awkward timing for the airline, so Qantas has revealed that Alan Joyce has pocketed more than $10 million worth of shares for meeting the company's COVID recovery goals. Now, it was required to report this information to the share market this week as part of an update on shares given to executives under a particular scheme. But it was published just hours after the consumer watchdog says it wanted to hit the airline with a record fine for allegedly misleading consumers. Now, the ACCC has launched legal action after Qantas was accused of selling tickets to flights that were already cancelled. So the company will no doubt be cringing to see Alan Joyce's pay packet in the limelight today. Now, in the days ahead, attention will turn to the pay packets of other Aussie workers. The federal government is pushing ahead with proposed changes to the industrial relations system aimed at closing loopholes that allow workers to be exploited. News Corp is reporting this morning that it'll include a move to allow union officials to turn up to workplaces without notice and inspect payroll records if they suspect wages are being underpaid. The Employment Minister will table the bill in Parliament next week. So,
Fiona Willen, live for us in Canberra this morning. Thank you.
Welcome back to Weekend Today on this Saturday morning. If you feel like you've had a bit of a bad week, spare a thought for Qantas. Although, it's not much sympathy this morning for the Aussie airline as it faces the prospect of a big fine for misleading customers. And this morning as well, news, outgoing boss Alan Joyce is set to pocket millions of dollars in bonuses. Let's bring in today's talkers, Carly Porch from Hit WA and 2GB's Clinton Maynard. Good morning to you both. Clinton, I'll start with you in the studio. A $10 million sweetener for Alan Joyce. Does he deserve it?
Well, he's happy, isn't he?
He's very happy. He's smiling all the way to the bank.
He doesn't deserve it because he's insulted and Qantas have insulted the Australian flying public. He's getting that bonus because of money the government paid Qantas during COVID to allow Qantas to survive. But do you remember what happened during COVID and then after COVID? There are all the delays at Sydney Airport, all the delays at Melbourne Airport, and Alan Joyce blamed the passengers.
So should he go now?
Yeah, why not? He should. And he'll be very happy with his $10 million, but will the board be happy when they cop a $600 million fine?
Well, that's a point, isn't it? Hey, Carly, to you in Perth, have Australians fallen out of love with the flying kangaroo, do you think?
I agree. I mean, I think we have. It's been very turbulent for them in the last week. And I've got to tell you, as someone that, you know, relies on Qantas, especially to go and see family over East, I've kind of had enough of them. And then when you're hearing about the profits that they're making and the bonuses that they're giving themselves, you can't help but feel that we're the ones getting ripped off.